Hello everyone, this video is about a new Blender add-on I shared a short time back. With this add-on, users can assign one or more Bezier curves to any other Bezier curve as its shape key. To install the add-on, download the script file. The details are given in the video description. Open Blender, go to Edit Preferences, click on Add-ons, then click on Install. Select the script file you have downloaded and click Install Add-on from File. Then select the checkbox next to Assign Shape Keys option. And if you want to use this add-on in the subsequent sessions, then you can click Save Preferences and close the dialog. After you have installed the add-on, you should see a new panel in Active Tool and Workspace settings. The panel is called Assign Shape Keys. We'll start with a very simple example. I'll switch to top view by pressing 7 on numpad and add a Bezier curve. Then go to edit mode by pressing tab, select the right handle of the left vertex and press S0 to scale it to 0. Now we have a straight line. I'll just increase the bevel depth so that it will be easier to see this curve. And then I will add a circle, a Bezier circle, and increase the depth of this circle also. Now I select these two curves and then shift click on the curve that I want as a target. So let's make the straight line as the target and click the Active Tool and Workspace Settings tab. I'll just check this option and say Assign Shape Keys. And now you see that the circle is removed and it is assigned as the shape key of this line. Now let's see another quick example. I'll again add a Bezier curve. Again, scale the right handle of the left vertex to 0 to make the curve a straight line. Then select this vertex and extrude it by pressing E followed by Y in Y direction by exactly 2 units. Then again select the same vertex and extrude in X direction by pressing E followed by X. So again I extrude by 2 units in X direction and now we have this curve. Let's make it closed by clicking this option Cyclic U. Under Active Spline, we will set the handle type of all the control points to free and rotate this handle along Z axis by 90 degrees so that we have a closed rectangle. Now I'll add an arbitrary shape. So I'll add a Bezier curve, delete all the vertices and click this option Draw. With this tool you can directly draw Bezier shapes. So let me create a shape and tab out and I'll select this curve and increase the depth to 0.02. For this curve also let's set the depth value to 0.02. We have these two curves now and let me add one more and I'll select all these three curves by pressing A and let's make this rectangle the target. I'll again go to the Assign Shape Keys panel and click Assign Shape Keys and you will see that there are two new shape keys to this rectangle. The first one corresponds to the arbitrary shape that we created and the second one is the circle. Now let's quickly see the important options of this tool. With the first option, you can either retain or remove the original shapes that were created. In these two examples, we checked this option. So the original curves that we created were removed and only shape keys and targets were kept after the operation. But if I uncheck this option, let me just undo this. If I uncheck this option and click Assign Shape Keys, then the original paths are kept and a new target is added with the shape keys. So now we have the original curves as well as the one created by the add-on. In the Space option, you can specify whether the coordinates used of the shape keys are the world coordinates or the local coordinates. Again, continuing with the same example, I'll undo the operation and select the space to local space. Let's check this option also and I'll select all the curves and shift click the target and then click Assign Shape Keys. And now if I change the value of the shape key, you will see that the transformation happens in the local space. But in this particular example, we see that the shape key, that is the circle, is getting flipped and there is a reason to that. If you look at the directions of these curves, the direction of the segments of the circle is clockwise, that of the rectangle is anticlockwise. So if we simply switch the direction of the segments of this rectangle or the circle, this should fix the problem. So now here is a small quiz. You see the rectangle is getting rotated as it gets transformed into the circle. How can this rotation be prevented and the transition made smooth? Keep watching this video and you will find out the answer soon. Let's move on to the next option, vertex alignment. To demonstrate the use of this option, I have created one more shape, an octagon. I'll hide these two. Both these shapes have the same segment direction. Now let's assign this octagon as shape key to the rectangle. We'll use world space and keep the original curves. Now if you look at the transition, this particular vertex is getting mapped to this vertex of the octagon. That is, the top left vertex of the rectangle is getting mapped to the left top vertex of the octagon. There will be many situations where we want different kind of transition, that is different mapping order. So the tool provides this vertex alignment option. Let's say we want to map this particular vertex, that is the left top vertex, to the vertex that is situated on the left side of the two top vertices of the octagon. So this one to this. We can achieve that by changing vertex alignment to vertex coordinates. And we have three additional options here, value 1, value 2 and value 3. And all these three drop downs provide six different possibilities based on the coordinate values. Now we want to map this vertex to this one, so both of them have maximum y value from all the vertices belonging to that shape. So the first option will be max y, but we see here that there are two such vertices in both the shapes. So we need to further refine the criterion and specify the second value as min x, so that out of these two vertices, the one situated on the left will be aligned to its counterpart in the other shape. Let's try this out. And now you see that this particular vertex is getting mapped to the top left vertex of the octagon. Let's have another example. Here we have this arbitrary shape. Let's check the vertices. So this one has the maximum y value. Let's keep the option values the same. Since there is only one vertex with maximum y value in this shape, so this one will get mapped to that vertex out of these two top vertices, which has the least x value. Let's make the octagon the target and click assign shape keys. And we can see that this vertex is getting mapped to the topmost vertex of this shape. Similarly, the third value can be used if there are multiple vertices that fulfill both these criteria. And lastly, let's talk about this match parts option. For that, I'll delete these curves and add a text object. I'll just duplicate this and change the text string. Let me convert both these text objects to curves. So now we have these two curve objects. Each of them has four different parts, which are also called splines. Now let's assign this curve as shape key to this curve with the default options. And we see that the transition is quite arbitrary because there is no mapping of parts. And since the parts could not be mapped, the closed parts in the original curve, that is the cyclic splines, were converted into open parts, that is non-cyclic splines. But very often, we will need a part-to-part matching. For example, both these objects have four parts each, so it's quite natural to map these parts one-to-one from left to right. So this match parts option is designed precisely to cater to that need. When I enable match parts, I again see three different criteria based on which the parts can be matched. These criteria have multiple options again, and most of these options are based on the bounding box of the part. Bounding box is the minimum rectangle, or in case of 3D shapes, it is the minimum cube that can fit the entire part. So when we select the first criterion as min x, this means that these parts will be ordered based on the minimum x coordinate of their bounding boxes. And then after the ordering, the parts will be mapped to each other. So let's set the first criterion value to min x. And since all the curve parts have distinct min x value, there are no parts that have the same min x value. We need not worry about the other criteria. The first criterion is enough to determine the ordering of the parts. So I have selected min x as the value and let me click assign shape keys. So here we see the parts are mapped based on their min x value. Now let's quickly see another example where the part counts don't match. Let me convert this to curve. And again we will keep the same criteria for matching parts and click assign shape keys. The tool has done the target to shape key mapping in case of the first three letters since it could find a one-to-one match. But for the last four letters of the first object, there is just one part remaining. So all these parts are mapped to this last object. The other options include the bounding box surface area, the bounding box height, the bounding box width and the depth, and the vertex count. So there could be a number of situations where it may be necessary to match the parts based on one of these criteria. And again, if there are more than one parts which fulfill the first criteria, the tool will use the next criterion to determine the ordering and so on. And before closing, let's add the answer to the quiz question. The question was, if you assign this circle as shape key to this rectangle, the rectangle is rotated during the transition. How can we prevent that and make the transition smooth? So let's see why the rectangle gets rotated. If we look at the vertices, there is just one top vertex in circle, whereas there are two vertices in rectangle. And one of them will necessarily get mapped to this one. So let's say if this gets mapped to this, this will get mapped to this, leading to the rotation of the rectangle. To prevent that, what we can do is rotate this rectangle along z-axis by 45 or minus 45 degrees and then apply the rotation because the transition is in local space and set the vertex alignment to max y so that this vertex gets mapped to this and there is a smooth transition. You can rotate the rectangle back to its initial position and now the transition is smooth. And that's it for now. If you have any suggestions or feedback, please leave them in the comment section of this video. Thank you very much.